Hello there, music lovers and fan of the audio. I'm George from Audiophile Heaven, and today we're having a look at a Romanian EM. This is the Meze Rai Penta, the flagship from Meze Audio. This is an in-ear flagship. I am now back with the Penta. The Penta is a 5-driver EM. As the name says, they have 4 custom ballast armatures. Custom means that they are made for it, and they have 1 dynamic driver inside the EM. This is an image of the EM exploded, which means that you can see what is inside the EM. They have a pretty low impedance of just 20 ohms, and they have a very high sensitivity of 100 decibels. The Rai Penta has a pretty nice overall package. It is a very simple cardboard box, but it has a pretty cool style to it. And I'll be honest with you, the EMs actually came in those 2 places, but I placed them inside the carrying case for a more practical presentation. They come with a ton of ear tips, which means that they will be ready for you, regardless of your ear's shape, size, and preferred comfort. They have everything ready for you, and they come with a very high quality carrying case. This is their carrying case, and I'm not going to lie, it is a very good one. The carrying case is actually made of leather. You can smell that leather. Leather usually has a unique, specific smell. So if you ever want to test if something is real leather or pleather or plastic, you can smell it. Leather will always have a specific smell. You cannot really get rid of that smell if you are using real leather. So yeah, that is the best test you can make. And I'm giving that to you as an advice, because a lot of people are selling stuff that is not actually made of leather, and if you are a fan of that, go ahead. Also, if you are a vegan and if you want to avoid leather products, that goes both ways. Make sure to smell it, and if it smells like leather, then it is leather. The headphones also come with even more EMs inside the carrying case, so yeah, the guys at Meze are not joking when they want you to have a good fit with their EMs. I actually am a big fan of that, and I consider that a very good fit is important for the end sound, because the Meze Rai Penta has a very good fit by default for me, with the medium-sized single-flanged tips, but for other people, they will require spin fit or comply or other style of tips. The sound is not the type that would typically ask for comply, because they are a smooth, musical sounding EM. They are very comparable to the DaVinci 9, which I have just reviewed even in writing, and they have a very musical type of sound. Meze seems to be going for that bassy, smoother, slightly rolled off type of sound. Many of their EMs and headphones have that type of sound. The only exception is the Empyrean, which supposedly is pretty neutralish and is more similar to Hi-Fi Man Aria than it is similar to Rosun Red Zero, which was a pretty smooth and warm sounding headphone. The design of the Rai Penta is actually very beautiful. It is a very good looking EM. Although it is not quite as lucrative as some of the Chi-Fi stuff I've been reviewing, it is pretty cool. It is made entirely of metal, the cuts are very ergonomic, it is very rounded on the inside, it has a good length to its bore so that it sits comfortably in your ear, it has a hole here for the driver, because having a dynamic driver, it leads a ventilation. Otherwise, you are going to get a pretty high amount of void in your ear, or you could even end up having driver flex, since they have a dynamic driver. Happily, there is no driver flex with the Meze Rai Penta. The comfort is good, as I said, the body is not too large, although they are on limit for my ears. So if you have smaller ears, I would suggest purchasing from somewhere that has good returns, because if you have a very small ear, they may not fit. The body is quite large, and it is quite large in the back. Basically, from this position where your ear canal would be all the way to the back, it is quite large also here, which is going to touch the back of your ear. They are not going to be comfortable for everyone, but for me they are very good. So for medium and large sized ears, they are very good. Despite having a ventilation port, I'm having between 10 and 20 decibels of passive noise isolation, depending on the frequency we're talking about, and I'm barely hearing myself talk. They are not quite as open as Final Audio EMs are in general, and they are very good if you need an isolating experience. They designed the ventilation to go one way, so that air can travel but not sound. They are quite leaky though. They leak a bit of sound, just like Final Audio. And on that note, you aren't going to be able to blast some of that death metal in a library, or else guards may throw you out of the library. Anyways, who goes to listen death metal in a library? I never wondered myself that. So why am I using that comparison at all? The cable is of a pretty good quality. It's very flexible, but it is not tangle prone. I just had it lying around in the case. I usually do this. I coil it around my hand and then place it in my pocket, and it doesn't really tangle. It doesn't really end up a mess. So that is a good thing. I'm pretty happy about the fact that they used a high quality cable. The cable is ended in a 3.5 millimeter jack, plated with rhodium rather than gold. A lot of companies, especially cable companies, have pointed out that gold is not exactly the best conductor in the world, and plating everything with gold is not necessarily going to make the thing better. Gold has its own usages, but the plating on the Mezes cable being plated with rhodium works very well as well. I have detected no issues with the cable. There is no microphonic noise. There is nothing to be worried about. One of the issues I have noted with them though is that despite having a very high overall CPL and very low impedance, they are actually not the easiest to drive. And if you listen very loud, you need a very high quality source to get the most out of them. So anything upwards of Ibesso DX160, for example DX220 or DX220 Max, or Fios M11 Pro is going to do very well with the Mezes iPenta. Also, Opus the Second will do very well, and QLS QA361 is going to do well. With less expensive setups, the experience varies a bit. Because they are a smooth sounding EM and a pretty musical sounding one, they need a pretty bright and pretty sparkly and pretty spicy kind of source. So something like the Audirect Beam 2 does a very good job with the Mezes iPenta, but something like the Audirect Atom Pro really doesn't do such a great job, because as they are already pretty smooth and pretty warm, adding a source that is also smooth and warm results in a sound that is quite too much. I mean, I didn't really like them with warm or with smooth sounding sources. As I was saying, the closest EM to compare to them are the DaVinci 9. The DaVinci 9 is the less one driver but very different sounding EM from DaVinci. I always praised their DaVinci 10 because the DaVinci 10 was absolutely exceptional in every way possible. The DaVinci 10 was like the end game for all EMs. You couldn't really outdo the DaVinci 10 at the moment it was released. But right now I also have Finals A8000, which may be able to do that. We'll find out in the video. And the DaVinci 9 was very musical. It was a warmer kind of EM, but not necessarily thick. It doesn't really choke you with that bass. It presents a very warm and musical presentation, also very large, very, very large, like a speaker. This is the kind of presentation that the iPenta goes for. They go for the exact same thing, but one of the major differences I've noticed are that the iPenta has a slightly better overall headroom. So if you wanted to EQ them, you could EQ them a bit more. They also have a slightly less textured but better controlled bass. Because they have a dynamic driver, it means that they are able to explore the bass lower, also with less distortion. Because balance armatures are not quite as good as going low in the bass, the iPenta manages to go quite a bit lower without any distortion. That being said, those differences are minute, and you should keep that in mind, because something like the iPenta is a bit less expensive than the DaVinci 9, but the differences are not quite that high. So even having them side by side and volume matched, you may not be able to tell for sure which you like better. I actually prefer them both. They are two flavors of one thing. So although they go for a pretty similar overall sound, they are flavors of that sound. For example, I have found out that the iPenta works very well with specific music. For example, with very dark cabaret and with dark jazz, they work very well. Where the DaVinci 9 works a bit better with classical than the iPenta. iPenta tends to struggle a bit with classical, where it does human voices a bit better. It also does very well with hip hop and with a more aggressive music, where DaVinci 9 was a bit too slow and too romantic for more aggressive music. So I found that the iPenta is a slightly better all-rounder. If you need a very good all-rounder, the iPenta should be the one for you. If you need something that sounds very good, that pairs very well, and that is pretty good in the general sense, even in the ergonomics, the iPenta should be the one for you. The DaVinci 9 is still no less an amazing EM, and the soundstage is a bit larger on the DaVinci 9, where on the iPenta it is not quite as large, but it is still very large. It is pretty huge. The instrument separation is a bit better on the right penta at the moment of making this video, so they are pretty well matched, I would say, despite the right penta being a bit more affordable. This may be a bit uncharacteristic for me to say, but you could actually drive the Meserai Penta from a smartphone. This is the Xiaomi Redmi Note 9S, and it is not the best smartphone in the world, but when plugging in, the Rai Penta detects their impedance, and I noticed that it does this with a lot of headphones, and when connecting this to the head of my car, I get mixed results, because sometimes it detects the impedance properly, while other times I get a pretty distorted sound because it believes it has another impedance. But at any rate, this one is actually quite capable of driving the Meserai Penta 9, so don't let my previous statements scare you. You could enjoy them out of a portable. You just need to match the Rai Penta with something that really sounds good as a portable. Even Hidizus EPI 80 Pro could do quite well, especially if you want to EQ them. The MSEB equalization from Hibi is one of the most practical equalizations on the market at this moment. If you want to take the most you can out of Rai Penta, you should try to EQ them a bit. Until I'm making the full written review, I will try to create some EQ profiles and let you know how the EQ went, and in the full written review, I will let you know other things I have felt about them and how I could get to enjoy more the Rai Penta. I hope this video has been enjoyable to watch. Don't forget to press that like button if you enjoyed this video. Also press subscribe for more content from me. I hope you have a lovely week in there, and we'll see each other really, really soon, hopefully.